Yo, what's going on, everyone? Welcome back to the channel. In this video today, I'm going to be using marksman rifles because I'm working on gold guns for them right now. How many gold guns do you have so far, and are you enjoying Modern Warfare 2? Are you somewhere in between? Leave your thoughts in the comments section below. As you saw in the title of this video, weapon tuning has been removed from Call of Duty Modern Warfare 2 temporarily. This is due to some sort of bug causing games to break and inevitably crash, making people need to reload. They sent out this tweet last night saying, "We are disabling attachment tuning until further notice to investigate crashes for users with 5 attachments tuned. If you currently have a tuned attachment equipped, you will need to unequip it and re-equip it to use your loadout." So, as of creating this video, this is still an ongoing issue. If you get to max rank with your weapon and you're wondering why weapon tuning isn't there, well, this is the answer. And when is this going to be fixed? We don't really know. It is a Sunday after all, but also since it's launch weekend, I would imagine that they have more hands on deck than usual, so there's a chance that this may get fixed by later tonight, but to be honest, I don't see them fixing this until tomorrow or maybe even Tuesday at this point. So weapon tuning will be on the back burner for now, and as soon as it goes live again, I will make sure to let you all know right here on the channel. I did have a little bit of time to use weapon tuning, and I thought it was really cool. I never had 5 on at once, so this is something I never personally experienced, the crashing that is. But from what I was able to use for the short time period that we had it, it was pretty dang cool. And I really liked being able to focus all of my attention on recoil control versus ADS, or ADS versus recoil control. It made things a lot snappier, it made things feel better at range, and overall, weapon tuning, big win. So I can't wait for it to come back. So there's actually another feature that I'm patiently waiting for the return of, which you may not have even noticed was removed, and that is pinging. Being able to ping enemies or locations or weapons on the ground to let your team know where you're going. Even if you want to ping objectives to let your team know, hey, we need to capture B or whatever. That was mysteriously removed, and I just found out what happened to pinging, so I want to share it with everybody. But essentially what was going down is if you pinged someone directly, very similar to Warzone, it would actually put a red mark above the enemy's head. Now this red mark would be fine and dandy if it lasted for maybe a couple of seconds, but for some reason it was lasting indefinitely throughout the entire match. So if you pinged someone directly, it wouldn't actually disappear, it would just always be there, creating many problems. So not only was it an annoying factor, but it was also really game-breaking, and because of this, Infinity Ward removed the feature temporarily, just a couple of hours after the game ended up launching. So I'm hoping to see a return of that. Pinging in multiplayer has always been a really good thing, specifically for those who maybe can't use a microphone, maybe don't have access to a microphone, or maybe you just don't want to talk to people, you're just feeling a little bit antisocial. You have all the controls you need right there at your fingertips in order to communicate where you're going, what you're doing, what you're focusing on, and that's why the ping system is amazing. So hopefully we'll see a return of that. And the attachment tuning in some sort of future update, maybe as soon as tomorrow, but hopefully at least by the end of next week. We did, however, get an update last night, an actual hotfix that dropped for Modern Warfare 2 to tackle another bug that people had been experiencing since the beta, and now it's still here in the full game, and that is crashing when partying up. It is an unfortunate thing. This has been happening for nearly every Call of Duty now for the past 5 or 6 years, as I can remember. But partying up with friends will sometimes cause you, as the host, to have your entire system crash and you need to restart your game. Or the friends that you're partying up with will inevitably crash as well. And on launch night, this was pretty dang bad. Like, to the point where I wasn't really even able to party up with anybody successfully. After the update went live yesterday, I did see significant improvements, but there were still crashes that were happening, just not nearly as much. So this is going to be one of those back and forth tug of war situations with this particular nasty bug, and I'm really, really hoping that they can get it down pat soon, because my goodness, the community already has to go through a pretty atrocious fight when it comes down to the user interface in this game, trying to invite people and just kind of get a party together, but it has been working much better now, I can confirm. But I did notice that there are some other things causing games to crash. Like, for example, if you're playing a game of Ground War and you decide, I don't want to play it anymore, so you want to leave, or maybe you just rage quit, that will sometimes cause your game to crash. Or even just backing out of the Ground War menu to go back into the regular menu to go to Quick Play Filter, that will also cause your game to crash. So there's a lot of things stemming from the UI, it seems, causing the game to crash, and I'm really, really hoping that that just gets fixed sooner than later. I also forgot to mention in my video yesterday, the Call of Duty Endowment released a brand new 10-item endowment protector pack. It's going to cost $9.99, no COD points involved. This is a limited time only bundle, and once it's gone, there's a good chance that they probably won't bring it back, but we've seen them bring back packs like this in the past. 100% of the proceeds on these packs go towards helping veterans secure high-quality jobs. They've been doing this now for years and years, and I always really appreciate when they do. Activision actually gave me a bunch of codes to give away, so if you are on PlayStation, Xbox, or Battle.net, here are some codes. I'm just going to go ahead and put them up on the screen. Enjoy. Hopefully you guys get one of them. First come, first serve. I know there's probably going to be a bunch of people that watch this video, so there you go. I'll put some more in the comment section below if I happen to find any. And I really, really appreciate you guys just stopping by, watching my videos, and keeping me in mind when it comes to your Call of Duty fix. I really do appreciate that. I know that there's going to be situations in the future where I end up getting more codes and stuff like this, maybe even COD point giveaways and things like that. So if you want to stay up to date and know when I do them first, make sure to follow me over on Twitter, which will always be linked in the description below. Big thank you to the awesome folks over at Activision for providing me with some codes to give away to my community. Now, last but certainly not least, I want to show you some gameplay of Drop Zone. And you might be wondering to yourself, how the heck is that possible? This footage was actually sent to me by a follower of mine over on Twitter, that Belgian dude. He ended up joining into a match of Hardpoint, and for some reason, from the very beginning of the match all the way to the end, care packages were being littered all over the map. Now, whether this was a bug or somebody doing something nefarious in-game, I'm not entirely sure, but this is pretty damn cool to see. Alongside this, we did also get some leaks that are talking about some game modes that we're actually going to be seeing in the future, and Drop Zone is part of those leaks. The other modes included are Reinforce, Gun Game, Infected, Uplink, Cranked, Cyber Attack, Team Defender, and finally, Grind, which is one of my favorites. But I cannot believe how chaotic this gameplay is. If you want to see the entire thing from start to finish, by the way, I'll put a link in the description below so you can check it out. It was uploaded a couple of days ago. It's really, really crazy. Thank you once again to that Belgian dude for shooting this over to me, because it is fascinating to watch. I haven't seen anyone else talk about this, nor have I experienced this while playing Hardpoint myself. Anyway, that is going to be it for today's video. Thank you all so much for watching. If you all enjoyed the conversation, please do me a favor, leave a like on it. Subscribe for more videos coming every single day. And don't forget to ring that bell icon next to the subscribe button. That way YouTube will notify you every single time my videos go live. Alrighty, folks, I'll catch you on the next one. Peace.